they're back. So apparently, we are only going to need to sculpt or add technically 6 horns. For now, we will focus on his big ones, which means I have to sculpt or indicate where all brow ridges are going to be. Just do that using a oh-so-fancy Sharpie. This is actually the most planning I've ever had to do on a custom, or custom pony. Most others have been pretty self-explanatory, even the Angel of Death one that I had to do. Which, if you all have remember seeing that, yes, it was another challenge. My first major challenge. Well, after that one bi-wing pony that I did several years ago. And I'm going to say that little tiny horn of his on the side is going to go there. And this is where that ridge of his is going to go. So if you can see, big horn, high parsley, medium horn. Medium horn, and then the little tiny ones that stick out on the bottom. Hi! Hi! Meow! This might get a little noisy. Just gotta attach my drill bit here. Would help if I lock that piece. No parsley. Kitties that are demanding of attention. Every time I'm working, you want my attention. Every single time. Yes, I know. Every single time. Okay. And we're scaring the cat. My purpose in life is to scare my kitty. Now let's see if this will actually work. Lobotomy on pony head! Okay, we got that one. Tony lobotomies! A good mess. Pony lobotomy. Okay. Hi again, Parsley. wire. And chuck it anywhere. We're not gonna get fancy. All I'm gonna do right now is just get some epoxy sculpt mixed to help anchor those two skeleton pieces in. With epoxy sculpt, get out of here. I noticed that the older your epoxy sculpt is, of course, the harder it's going to be. So to kind of get rid of that graininess that happens when you after mixing, add a little bit more of the gray part, which is part B, than you do with your colored part, part A. And again, follow the rules of working small batches, because this stuff will start to harden really quick. I know the instructions, they say mix for about, like, 2 minutes or so. Say, so long as you don't see any solid gray parts anymore, you're fine. Oh, and always have water on hand. The stuff will stick to everything. So I guess, like, with when you're using your, oh god, what's the other stuff you guys sculpt with? Fimo, and Super Sculpty. They don't use water, they use, like, oil or something. But you can kind of get away with that with those, because you can wipe away. This, I can't see you trying to mix or use water to smooth anything out. I don't know how it would affect the strength of your finished piece, so I just use water. Looks good to me. It's a little bit lighter now. My sculpting tools out. And again, because this is just being used at the moment to anchor, just going with any old tool I have right now that'll help me push down the edges. Why this works, but I find if you push a little bit of the epoxy sculpt into your hole and then stick your wire back in, it can help secure your horns, wings, tail, whatever, even a little further. And again, because I'm using the original ponies inside of your skull to counterbalance, it's helping too. And again, parsley. Keep your hands wet, but this stuff will, again, stick to everything, including your skin.